Congratulations.
Thank you.
Just go on honeymoon, you have to get away till.
No, yeah. Yeah, we just went to, we went to Asheville, North Carolina.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's just called the
Mountain. Oh, that's beautiful.
It's like North Carolina is not.
Yeah, right.
Council meeting minutes August 26th, 2016.
Special Committee of the Whole Meeting Minutes, August 22nd, 2016. And to reappoint Jordan Greenwald to the Civil Service Commission for a six-year term.
Motion to approve is presented.
Second.
Keith?
Abstain.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
By yes, my abstain to approve the resolution.
All right, thank you. At this time, recognition of visitors. Mr. Revolt, please.
Daryl Revolt, 1565 Amherst, Southwest, North Canton. Jeff, I want to thank you for the courtesy of returning my call on Saturday. We're on vacation, and I appreciate the time that you spent. I'm here tonight to ask council to consider tabling ordinance 52-2016. Proposed legislation, which deals with CRA, essentially mirrors what it replaces, and particularly it's the Section 5 of 107. If one argues that the Northridge apartment was allowable under 107.9.5-10, then I think we can agree that the old language and the new language, which are almost identical, lack transparency, accountability, and oversight. I'd like to urge council to consider reviewing five CRA ordinances from surrounding communities. Each of these is slightly different in emphasis. For example, in Hudson, there's no residential CRA permitted. Stowe only allows residential CRA in what's called mixed use. And in Worcester, you can only receive an abatement on remodeled property. And apartment complexes are deemed commercial, which require negotiation with the school system. I think on one of these CRA documents, you will find a solution to your dilemma here. I want to make sure that with all the comments that surround this, that council understand how important it is to have a CRA ordinance in place. Clearly, for the commercial and residential side, it is critical for redevelopment, particularly as you look along Main Street, which is where it was originally established. It's very important to have. But again, what's important is that the process for that CRA be open and transparent. That is absolutely critical if we're to have the confidence of the taxpayers. Because clearly, at the end of the day, we're in inherent conflict when we evade taxes with our school district. And we clearly understand how critical that school district is to our own well-being as a city. So, that concludes my remarks. I would certainly encourage you again to table this. Mr. Peters, I have a copy that's hot off the press. You're welcome to it.
Yes, sir.
And, I think this one doesn't have any notes.
Thanks
very much. Thank you very much for your
courage. Thank you. As it relates to 5216, it's on the agenda under an emergency. We're only going to have a first reading tonight and keep things moving along. We are going to discuss this in committee next week. Anyone else wishing to address council, please step forward. Ms. Kaufman.
Marion Watson, 320 River Avenue. I just heard 3 minutes ago that ordinance 49-2016 was tabled, that I prepared remarks, and I'm going to go ahead and say them because it will, then you will know why you will table it, okay? When all of you took the oath of office, you swore to uphold the charter, ordinances, the resolution, and the laws of the state of Ohio. The city charter, the city ordinances, and the Ohio Revised Code are the infrastructure of North Canton city government. Tonight you have a third reading of a zoning ordinance involving violation of 118.04 of the zoning ordinance. I forgot to give you my handout. On page one is the actual copy of the zoning book, which shows 1181.04, which says, after the adoption of a resolution by council, the motion or resolution shall be reviewed and considered by the planning commission. The word is shall, which is a very strong legal term. It doesn't say may, maybe, or can, it says shall. So if you want to change the zoning to allow parking in someone's front yard, then it has to go to planning commission to be reviewed first. So on page one, that tells what our ordinance is. If you go to page two, it's the Ohio Revised Code, 713.10. Which talks about when you change zoning, and this 713.10 also captures 713.07 through 713.09. And the second paragraph says, the legislative authority of such a municipal corporation may amend or change the number, shape, area, or regulations of an intending district, but no such amendment or change shall become effective unless the ordinance proposing is first submitted to the planning commission. Again, the word shall. Doesn't say may, doesn't say maybe, doesn't say can. And then I'll direct you to page three, which is 713.07, and in this, which is also part of 0.10, it says other structures and premises. And if you go to page four, it's the Merriam-Webster dictionary. It says what a premise is. The simple definition of premise is a building and the area of land that it is on. So this ordinance refers to also the land. So I hope indeed that you do table this ordinance so that you can follow the ordinance in ORC, send it to the planning commission where it goes through the process. And I guess my big question is, why are we even doing this?
I can answer that for you if I can interject here for a minute.
No, that's okay. I'd like to continue. Okay. I think you're shooting a mosquito with a cannon. Why are you changing the whole city ordinance for one person? We have a zoning board of appeals. And as long as the neighbors on each side or across the street have no problem with what these people want to do, the zoning board of appeals will okay it. You're going to open yourself wide open to make it citywide. Think about it. You're going to have cars parked there that don't run. You're going to have cars parked there that are for sale. It's going to look terrible. Terrible to have parking lots in the front yard. And if it's citywide, people will take advantage of it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm not sure exactly what you guys got in your packet, but on my agenda, motion a second to table, so it must not have made it onto your packet, but I have mine right here. It says we are tabling, and that was our intent. I had to put on the agenda to table. I didn't want to leave it hanging out there. Well, as it relates to opening up a can of worms, you were here for those discussions prior meetings, and here when the young lady requested that. One of the things that came up was, we have older housing stock that are smaller pieces of property, single car driveway, single car garage. And that's the home that my wife and I first bought. And there were two drivers that was a pain, moving cars in and out. And, you know, as if you have, the family has children and they have a third child, or a first child, and a third car, then you're gonna have issues. And, you know, I don't want, what this council is trying to do is to preserve the housing stock. I have rentals up and down the main corridor where this really is a problem. I think it's a common sense measure that we're gonna put in place to effectively make some of those properties along the main corridor more attractive to younger families, not just investors looking to rent them out. But I appreciate the comment. If anyone else wants to address council, please step forward.
Golden Sailor, 340 Reed Avenue, North Kent. Come to talk about CRA tonight. First, I'd like to talk about the application that was submitted to the county auditor in regards to the abatement of North Ridge Place, which I believe is a legal document, the way it's filed. And you can easily get this document either from, I got a copy from Mr. Grimes, also got a copy from the Stark County Auditor's Office. But on the first page of that document, it says exemption sought for North Ridge Place. And it has there whether you're specifying it's new construction or remodeling. Mr. Bowles, that's right beside new structure, okay? Beside remodeling, put NA. Also on this document, you have to specify the section of the Ohio Revised Code. So on page 2, he uses section 3735.67 D1 or D2. I'd like you guys to write that down again and do some homework tonight. 3735.67 D1 or D2. If you look at those sections of the Ohio Revised Code, they refer to remodeling. Nothing about new construction. So clearly Mr. Bowles has submitted to the county auditor's office a document that's been falsified. And I plan to contact the auditor tomorrow and make this known to him, but I thought out of courtesy to this council that I'd let you guys know tonight, so hopefully tomorrow some action's done to go to the auditor's office and have this abatement removed. The auditor's office does have the ability to go back and reinstate those back taxes that have been abated. He's got that authority. And I think that's, you need to press the law director to do that. I also find it interesting that in the document package they got from the auditor's office, that Mr. Bowles references ordinance 22-99 as the reason for the abatement, not 5-10. But it doesn't really matter, because if you look at section 5 and all of the ordinance that covers CRA, there's three specifications. So again, look at section 5 and do your own work. Do not take the advice of the law director in this matter. It says plainly there in section 5, 10 years, section 5A of the ordinance. Is anyone you want to pick? 10 years for remodeling of dwellings, 2 units. B, section B, 12 years for remodeling of more than 2 units. And section C says 15 years for construction of dwellings as described and 3735.67 D3. If you look at that section, of the Ohio Revised Code, it refers to historical buildings, okay? And it actually refers back to D1 and D2 saying that you can give them more exemption because they are historic buildings. So plainly, there's nothing in any of the ordinances that cover new construction. And Mr. Fox explained at the last meeting that he went back and looked at through all of the proceedings for all of these ordinances, it doesn't matter. Okay? You have to strictly look at the ordinance and what's in there. There's nothing specifying new construction for residential property being abated. It's just not there. And I challenge Mr. Fox tonight to read specifically out of the ordinance where that is said. Because don't you think it's mighty strange that you're giving them a 12-year abatement on new construction? Why aren't you giving them 15 years? That's all I have to say. Thank you.
To redo what was done in error. And as Glenn has pointed out, Section 5C on how that those ordinances were invalid on the form that Mr. Bowles submitted to the auditor for Northridge. On page 2 of 52-2016, I want you to note that Section 5C, 15 years, the Ohio Revised Code numbers and the numbers that he was referencing are omitted from this. So it seems to many of us that this is a maneuver. So would you please think about what you're doing to the schools? The schools do not want new construction. So we are going forward. Please consider that. All of us are responsible for educating our young, and you have the authority to make sure that the money that voters vote for when they vote for a school levy actually goes to the schools rather than an entity that, in my opinion, doesn't need it. So let's make sure when voters vote for a school levy, that money goes to the district and not developers. Thank you.
Thank you.
Melanie, I want to make a comment on that real quick. This is not a maneuver. I mean, this is pretty straightforward. Repealing the ordinances that don't have state certifications, that's all we're doing is cleaning it up. The other ones do have state certifications. You can see that. It's on record. But there is no maneuver here. And we're only having one reading, or we're having the first reading. It's not going to be an emergency. We're going to still walk that. We're going to discuss further next week.
Helen, one question. Do you think the schools don't want commercial or residential new? You don't think they want anything? Or you just refer to residential?
Am I allowed to speak?
Yes. She's asking you a question.
Come up. Come up so you're here.
Come on up.
It's my understanding with conversations from with the schools, they do not want any new construction in this CRA. The current boundaries, Main Street, Valley View. So it is no new construction. That's particularly for residential. Unfortunately, North Canton has apartment complex zoned for residential.
And I want to be very clear, this council has gone on record and say we are opposed to new residential. And you know that's not what this that's not what the CRA was intended for. And you know, I discussed it in like at length with Mr. Revolt. And but I want to make very clear too, for some of the folks, and Darrell, I'll give you a minute here. I want to be very clear, some of the folks that are here don't understand the process. We are a legislative body. Okay, we're not an administrative body. We legislate the CRA ordinance, we enacted them. You know, it was up to the way it's written, the way the state statute is written, that the housing officer implements those. The thing that, Glenn, that you had you brought from the state auditor, we didn't see that. That's not under our purview. An administrative function. So, but I'm very interested in seeing that. And I appreciate that. Darrell, come on. I know you want to make some more comments. I mean, just very interesting. This whole thing is that important to everybody up here for us, for everybody to be clear. I mean, we've been accused of making maneuvers or whatever. This is pretty serious, and we care about this, so that's why I'm allowing Darrell to come back up.
Thank you. The difference between a residential CRA and a commercial industrial is that under the latter, you collect income tax. And that little phrase about negotiating with the school board, the agreement which you approve, in effect establishes a pilot, a payment in lieu of taxes. So you can go out and abate, if you will, a commercial or industrial property. But what you would be doing then is whole. The issue with Northridge, unfortunately, is that the tax was abated, and there's no pilot. There's no payment of taxes, so they're out the cash. That's where I think this the materials that I presented to Jeff, I think if you take a look at it, you'll see the nuance where various other communities are attempting to protect their schools, but yet simultaneously promote economic development. I think it'll be there, and I think you'll find that. Thank you.
Thanks, Darrell. Okay. Anyone else wishing to address council?
There is still only 373 Pershing Avenue Northeast. I know this is going to be off topic since it's not about zoning. But one of the things I've noticed when you're driving westbound towards 77 with Pittsburgh and Portage, you could barely see that light. And you end up stopping there just because you don't know whether it's red or green. And it becomes very dangerous if you don't know whether it's red or green, because what if someone thinks it's green, they just drive through and cause an accident just because they couldn't tell. A traffic light has to be distinctive. You should easily be able to tell whether it's red or green and not just guess, which is many cases now. Because if I'm driving there, I'm slowing down just to see where the light is. And I figured if I can't see it, it's red, and if I can barely see it on the bottom, it's green. This is not a safe situation. And I've seen that point for a while. It needs a different light that you can see that is a lot safer than to avoid accidents.
Yeah, is that the light, which, Pittsburgh?
By Ernie's bicycle?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the one light.
South on Pittsburgh?
It's by
Ernie's. I've seen both lights, is what you're saying.
You can't see either one. No. So it's all the fixing problem.
Because of the sunset.
I had trouble this morning.
Going west. Yeah. Towards the
ocean. Gary, what direction are you traveling in? You're saying
it's not south on Pittsburgh Road, you're saying you're coming to
Portage. Right. Like I'm coming from here over to the freeway.
West on Portage.
Oh, that's west on Portage.
Right.
So if you have Ernie's bike to the right of
the right.
Correct. That light, when you're coming up on it, you're saying whether it's
on the right hand side before you get to the intersection of this light shop.
Okay. So it's not that you can't see the lights, it's that you can't see the color which one's on.
Right. You can't tell whether it's red or green.
Right. Because of the brightness of the light and the bulb that's in there.
Okay. Right. And that causes a dangerous situation.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, the newer lights have the black square in the background, so it reflects better. Maybe it just might be something.
We do that for east and west traffic. I'll check the signature that's there. Also, the LED bulb, we'll make sure that we get LED bulbs.
Yeah, thanks for bringing that up.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're right. We did that on West Maple. I know across West Maple, you can see electric trees with a yellow background.
I thought we were going to get one at some point. This is only the first reading, but yeah.
We do want to downsize, downscale now.
Correct, yes. I like everything to be out in the open and I would.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, that's the plan. Thank you.
Thank you.
Chuck Osborne, 307 Fairview Street, Southeast North Canton, Ohio. It's very interesting to see how the rules change here from week to week. You've had all kinds of interaction here, follow-up. Anyway, so much to talk about here, I don't even know where to start. But since we're talking about the CRA, it's quite interesting, Mr. Peters, and you acknowledge that states never certified previous CRA ordinances. So that doubly backs up what Mr. Saylor said, and I've seen those documents. Mr. Bowles just basically falsified, for whatever reason. They're totally invalid. I don't know what your fancy attorneys and plumbers are telling you. You guys are in a world of hurt. The mayor has told you, you guys are all on board with him. It's stupid. There's no valid reason to even do it. And yet you're turning around and spending taxpayer dollars when you should be telling Mr. Lemon he owes the money back and the abatement should be terminated, as well as the one on harm. So I doubly back up, Mr. Saylor has said, what former Mayor Rabot has said, and let's get to Mrs. Baum. You're amending the zoning code, again, without following the zoning code itself. To amend the zoning code is like a 6-month process. Mr. Foltz has been through it with me. Mrs. Keesley has been through it with me. And he did it a year ago. And I'll never forget the words, Mrs. Keesley. Oh, it should never have been there, so we're just going to take it out. You have bypassed 2 public hearings. You have bypassed input from your planning commission. And you're just running ahead. So taking away the appeal to council last year isn't worth the paper it's printed on. Because somebody can litigate that and appeal to council. Because you guys did it totally wrong. And you're doing it again now. You're trying to stop in the middle of the process and say, well, we'll make a side trip over to the Planning Commission. What does that tell them? Do they have any value in this process? Hell no. Okay, we'll let them give their 2 cents worth, and then we'll just motor right along. Now, Marianne didn't come up with a word. It's a variance. Try it on an experimental basis. Help this woman get a variance. If the zoning board of appeals will approve it, and see how that works out. But you're going to destroy the city if you start to have people create a parking pad right in front of their house in their front yard. And these dinky little yards as it is. I think that was the code or your ordinance says 40% of the front yard can be a parking pad. Be fair to the future of the city. Give them a variance and see how that's going to work out. But people know this when they buy the home. These are the restrictions. What you should be doing is doing away with R50 housing. These homes will never be adequate in the future. I've told you, there's no place to park. If you've got multiple cars, you've got to shovel cars. There's no place to put your snow when you shovel. You could not fight a fire from either side of the house. Only you could fight it from the front or the back. R50 is totally antiquated and should be left in the dark, in the dirt. Regarding another recommendation as far as getting rid of R50, why don't you start enforcing your own zoning requirements? I call our permits and inspection today to report this neighbor about a block and a half down the street. I'll give you this, because I made 2 of them. He's got an engine block hanging off of a carrier. This car's been on blocks at least for a week. And I think it's a rental property. And I called down there, and Don, forget his last name, said, well, our part-timer was on vacation. He might be able to come over and get a picture of it, he may not. But anyway, here's a picture. Instead of giving abatements to multi-millionaires who have investment property, commercial property, please think of what you're doing. You should not be led down the path by a lawbreaker, and I don't know who he's marching to, but anyway, you're not following process, procedure, and it makes you just want to go home and blow your brains out, because this is pathetic.
That's
wrong. Jeff. It is. It depresses the hell out of me. I can't depend on a single soul here.
They've rented out this property to Wolf students. What did I tell you earlier, Mr. Grimes? I've seen as many as 8-9 cars in their driveway when I wake up in the morning. This would be about in the, on 11-27, probably in the 11-05 or 11-22 category on East Maple. A guy by the name of John Hunter owned the house. And he passed away a couple years ago. It's right in the same block where your sister or sister-in-law, whatever.
Jeff Rabbit.
Yeah. Yeah. It's terrible. Then, across the street to the east of me, two doors down, they also rent to Welsh College students. I've seen as many as six, seven cars. They drive across their yard to get out of the driveway. So before you even think of passing this, think of the consequences. But Mr. Osborne, what it's going to do to the city down the road, you're opening up a real can of worms. I've had one on my side of the street from some Oriental people. I've got pictures in my cell phone. Unfortunately, my printer doesn't work, or I would have had copies. Again, they just put in concrete that abuts almost up to their neighbor's lot so they could park additional cars. And now they were parking, the cars would come out on the sidewalk, the back end. So think before you even go any further with this. Thank you very much.
Vacation.
Oh, so
vacation.
So this is the third reading on vacation of the lot. And I was just, I've been bugging everybody to see if we could get an update on Uber. I know this is an important thing for the church, Uber, for the apartments, right? So they can have the parking. I would just like to see the corner and get an update. So I don't know if we have that.
We'll have that in the course.
Okay.
All right, I'm motioning out.
Did you say?
Second.
Yes.
Yes.
Folds.
Yes.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
And Peters.
Yes.
Six yes to adopt the third reading of ordinance number 47-2016.
Thank you very much. We have a motion and a second to table ordinance number 49-16.
So, second.
Sir Reddick.
Yes.
Folds.
Yes.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Peters.
Yes.
And Waring.
Yes.
Six yes to table ordinance number 49-2016.
Thank you very much. Now, on new business, may I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 52-16.
Second.
Folds.
Yes.
Fonte.
Let's stay.
Peterson.
Yes.
Peters.
Yes.
Waring.
Yes.
And Sir Reddick.
Yes.
By yes, one to abstain. First reading of ordinance number 52-16. And ordinance repeal of ordinances 5-10 and 107-09. Dividing ordinances 71-2004, 22-99, and 106-2000, and implementing the sections 37-35.65 through 37-35.70 of the revised code, thereby reducing and dividing the North Canton Community Reinvestment Area CRA into the former anatomy dividing Main Street CRA. Established under the ordinances 22-2000 and 106-2000 in the former and now revived Bellevue CRA under ordinances in 71-2004 within the City of North Canton redesignating a housing officer to administer the programs reestablishing the Community Reinvestment Housing Council and a tax incentive review council, repealing any and all legislation inconsistent therewith, and declaring seek to be an emergency.
Thank you, Chair.
As someone who's looking back at my minutes, I have in my minutes that it's ordinance 105-2000. Am I wrong, Chair? Tim? I'll take back on the minutes from last
week. No, it's 106. I mean, there's a typographical error.
From last week.
Your last.
Okay, because that's what I wrote in my notes and that's what I read in the
106.
Okay, so it is 106. All right. So I'll explain it the way I know. And if Tim wants to give any, if I'm wrong or incorrect. In ordinance 107-09 in 2009, we repealed that one immediately with ordinance 5-2010. However, those two, which is really one, ordinance never went down to the state and we never received a certificate certifying that CRA area. So we are currently going to repeal that CRA area that really doesn't truly exist, but we're going to get it off our books. It does not exist on the auditor's web for the state community development website that we've never received a certificate, which we confirmed through Jim. Therefore, they really truly don't exist. We need to get them off our books. With this ordinance, that's what we're doing.
Correct. I have confirmed with the Department of Development with what certifications that we have, and they're related to those prior ordinances, the 5-10 and 107-09. The only difference between those two is the 5-10, instead of having a meets and bounds property description, you have that. And everything else involving that are exactly the same. I have no evidence that Department of Development receive that or deny it even? There's, all I know is there's not a certificate, except for those earlier ones for the 7104, essentially the Main Street CRA and the Valley View. Those ones, we have certificates. You have to have the authority of the state in those certificates to issue those tax abatements. And so if you leave the ordinances that you have, as far as 5-2010, there's the presumption for someone to believe that expanded area is available for a CRA, which indeed it's not. It would be no different than if it was sent and for some reason there was a mistake. Maybe there was, but the only evidence I have is just the lack of a certificate. And so if you had sent it and there was some error and the state didn't approve it, you wouldn't be invalidating any of your prior certified community reinvestment areas. So what, in effect, this is trying to do is just make it clear and transparent for anyone that needs to understand where we do have community investment areas and what's available there, that they line up with the ordinances that we have in place. And that's what this will do. As Councilman Griffith has stated, once you revive those, repeal the other ones, then you have the opportunity, if you wish, to then amend those. You can be very specific. You can state then in those amendments whether or not you will permit new construction, residential, commercial, or industrial property. You may even be very clear, and I think that is the problem that we have with the Northridge CRA, is defining exactly what is residential and what is commercial property. So you may state in there that if you're going to permit new construction for residential property, you can state, and for the purposes of the CRA, that no more than, say, 4 units in a property will be considered residential. Anything above must be considered commercial. And so that others are aware, the issue of whether or not the housing officer has the authority to grant the tax abatement, once it's determined, housing officer is able to make that determination based on what we have in our housing codes, whether or not property is residential or commercial. If it's deemed residential by state statute, it's put in place for the reason to remove the politics from there. Only the housing officer is the one that has the authority to approve or deny. Can't go to council. This Supreme Court interpreting those rules of the state legislature as we just put in there is for the purpose of removing any politics, not having council members decide whether or not a tax abatement for residential property should or should not be approved. The state legislature has determined that is the sole decision of your housing officer. So what you're attempting to do here with these ordinances, as I said, is just make it clear that you don't have certifications for those broadened areas that happened in 09 and 10. And this brings it back to make it clear that those that are in effect are those prior ones.
One other question, would it be appropriate to the committee next week amend this legislation, talk about amending this legislation on its second and third readings to make the change that you'd like to see? Or would it be better to finish this out and then go back and amend?
that's a terrific question. The reason why you need to revive these is because if you wish to amend the meat of those in determining whether or not residential property is included for new construction or to change the thresholds or time periods for those that may receive abatements, then you would be required to send that amendment then to the state and ask the state, okay, for those that we do have certifications, we would like to amend what we have in place for some of those variables. You make that application if the state approves it, and it has done that. It's exactly what happened in the earlier ones for the Main Street CRA. There was absolutely, in the 06 and the 22, there was an amendment. And we have a certificate for the amended CRA. So we shouldn't amend the legislation, because in fact what we're asking to do is to revive it. And I think you're making it kind of messy and even more confusing than it may be in saying we're reviving it and why we're doing that, we're amending it, and then we're also sending it to the state for certification. So I think that the steps are, regardless, whether or not you change and revive and repeal these ordinances, we know it's clear that we only have authority to grant the abatements for which we have the certification, and those are for the 99 and 2000.
And both for the value.
Okay. Any questions? Not asking for an emergency, obviously. We will bring it back up to amend, but it appears as if we do need to repeal the two CRAs that really truly don't exist.
Yeah, it's not, think of it not necessarily repealing the CRAs, because we have those in place with the state. We have certifications that permit us to award those abatements. But what you do have is an attempt to amend those and expand those in an ordinance that ordinance has not received the certification from the state. So it's as though they're on our records, but they're ineffective because we have no authority to get the abatement unless we have the certificates.
Can we have the match in the next week then?
Sure.
Of the ones that will occur.
You sure. Have to do that.
Directing the mayor of the city of North Canton to execute a
Services Director Grimes the opportunity to go out and get bids for our contract in 2016, and I know you want to run an emergency.
Yes, if I can pass an emergency because I'm getting to a due date.
Yes, you are.
Is the contract 1 year or do you
contract for the independent energy consultants is 1 year. You can get out of it. It's been a perpetual one. There's a certain time that you can get out of that one. The one I was concerned with was the 2012, because it mentioned 4 years. It wasn't real clear to me, so I want to make sure I can come back and you know, get the 4 years in there. The company that actually supplies the gas in this particular is whatever we signed with. Obviously, we can't go more than 4 years. I don't know that we would go 4 years. Probably we go with 1 or 2 years. I'm looking probably at a 2 year contract for that.
I'm moving it up.
Okay.
Keeson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Larry?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
6
to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 53, 2016. Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to suspend the rules of council for 3 readings for ordinance number 53.
So moved.
Second.
Peters?
Yes.
Mary?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Coles?
Yes.
Conte?
Yes.
Keeson?
Yes.
6 yes to suspend the rules of council for 3 readings to ordinance number 53, 2016.
Thank you. Now may I have a motion and a second to adopt under suspension of the rules ordinance number 53-16.
So moved.
Second.
Mary?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
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 Eastland? Yes.
And Peters?
Yes.
6 yes to adopt under suspension of rules for ordinance number 53, 2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 54-16.
So moved. Second.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Ford?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Eastland? Peters?
Yes.
And Warren?
Yes.
6 yes to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 54, 2016, and ordinance amending section 20, compensation of chapter 155, personnel regulations of part 1, administrative code of the codified ordinance for the city of North Canton in accordance with North Canton ordinance number 37, 2016, to increase the bi-weekly compensation for the position of director of permits and development and extend the same to
thank you, and I spoke to the mayor earlier today, and we've got somebody
yes.
on board and ready to roll, and we just need to get this emergency of the off the job tomorrow, correct?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yeah, very good. So looking forward to this. So if there are no further questions, I'll entertain a motion in a second to adopt first reading.
So moved.
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Keeson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Warren?
Yes.
And Sir Reddick?
Yes.
6 yes to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 54, 2016.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to suspend the rules of council for 3 readings for ordinance number 54-16.
I move.
Second.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Keeson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Warren?
Yes.
Yes.
And
yes.
6 yes to suspend the rules of council for 3 readings for ordinance number 54, 2016.
Thank you. Finally, may I have a motion and a second to adopt the suspension of the rules ordinance number 54-16.
So moved.
Second.
Keeson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Warren?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
6 yes to adopt the suspension of the rules for ordinance number 54, 2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 55-16.
So moved. Second.
Peters?
fair deal for all involved, but saved us a ton of money in the process.
Yeah.
So, Chuck, I appreciate your hard work on that.
Thank you.
With that, I'll entertain a motion and second to adopt the first reading of ordinance 55-16.
So moved.
Second.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
And Peters?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 55-16.
You may have a motion and a second to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 55-16.
So moved.
Second.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
And Waring?
Yes.
Six chefs to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 55-16.
May I have a motion and a second to adopt under suspension of the rules of ordinance number 55-16?
So moved.
Second.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
And Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt under suspension of the rules for ordinance number 55-16.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 56-16?
So moved.
Second.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
And Folds?
Yes.
Six chefs to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 56-16 and ordinance approving, confirming, and accepting drainage easement known as parcel number 560-1942 being part of open space by between the city of Canton and Ohio Charter Municipal Corporation and the Century Office Association Inc. and declaring the same to be an emergency.
Thank you, Chairman Fontaine. Is your time to shine?
Time to shine. Okay, so we're going to shine for a potential storm sewer easement there at the backside of the sanctuary. And it's on emergency, so I move that we adopt the first reading.
Second.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 56-16.
Have a motion and a second to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 56-16.
So moved.
Second.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
And Peterson?
Yes.
Six chefs to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 56-16.
Thank you. Finally, we have a motion and a second to adopt under suspension of the rules of ordinance number 56-16.
Second.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt under suspension of rules for ordinance number 56-16.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 57-16.
So moved.
Second.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Yes.
Fontaine? Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
And Waring?
Yes.
Six chefs to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 57-16 and ordinance approving, confirming, and accepting the perpetual water main easement known as parcel number 100060042 and being part of a 9.40 acre land by between the city of North Canton and Ohio Charter Municipal Corporation, grantee, and bills at Kings Creek Condominiums, grantor, and declared the same to be an emergency.
Thank you, Fontaine.
Okay, so this is just a, an ongoing water main perpetual easement for the parcel there where the Kings Creek buildings are. And I move that we adopt the first reading.
Second.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt the first
So moved.
Second.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Six chefs to suspend the rules of council for three reading the ordinance number 57-2016.
May I have a motion in second to adopt under suspension of the rules ordinance number 57-2016?
So moved.
Second.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
And Fontaine?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt under suspension of the rules for ordinance number 57-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion in second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 58-16?
So moved.
Second.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
And Peterson?
Yes.
Six chefs to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 58-2016. An ordinance approving, confirming, and accepting a perpetual storm sewer and drainage easement known as parcel number 1-000-6130 and being part of a 4.70-acre tract of land by between the city of North Canton and Ohio Charter Municipal Corporation, ENT, and Kings Creek Association, LLC, Grant Board, and declaring the same to be emergency.
Thank you, Chairman Fuzzle.
This here is, again, this is an easement, water main easement, ongoing perpetual agreement for the Kings Creek Association. Bill is back there, so I move that we adopt that first reading.
Second.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
And Peters?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 58-2016.
May I have a motion in a second to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 58-16?
So moved.
Second. Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
And Waring?
Yes.
Six chefs to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 58-2016.
May I have a motion in a second to adopt under suspension of the rules ordinance number 58-16.
So moved.
Second.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
And Surratt?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt under suspension of rules for ordinance number 58-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion in a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 59-16.
So moved.
Second.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
And Golds?
Yes.
Six chefs to read by title only the first reading ordinance number 59-2016. An ordinance authorizing the mayor of the city of North Canton to prepare and submit an application to the Ohio Public Works Commission for the West Maple Street Project. The mayor upon board control approval to enter into an agreement for said plan and declare the same to be energy.
Thank you, Chairman Fuzzle.
Okay, so this is a good one. This is where they're talking about bringing to Main right there next to the bank, making an expansion there. This is the grant that we're trying to get, or we are going to get it hopefully, but the deadline is September 16th, and it's like $650,000, so it's on an emergency. So I move that we adopt this as soon as possible. Like right now.
Second.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt the first reading ordinance number 59-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion in a second to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 59-16.
So moved right now.
Second.
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
And Peterson?
Yes.
Six chefs to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 59-2016.
Thank you. Finally, may I have a motion in a second to adopt under suspension of the rules ordinance number 59-16.
So moved.
Second.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Six yes to adopt under suspension of the rules for ordinance number 59-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 60-16?
So moved.
Second.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Fields?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
And Mary?
Yes.
Six yes to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 62-16. In ordinance authorizing director of administration of the city of North Canton to advertise community bids for the city of North Canton drinking water treatment plant purifiers for the replacement project and authorizing the mayor upon board of control approval to enter into a contract for the project and declaring the same to be an emergency.
Thank you. Chairman Serrano.
With Dan's not here, I'll take over, but has anyone been able to go over and tour the EMS unit? This is for the EMS unit.
It was supposed to be tonight.
Right, okay. And I've been able to go over there, and Chief Bacon has taken me through. I want to add some living quarters. It's needed living quarters. We'll go over there and take a look.
That's the next one.
Yes, we're on 60.
Yeah, we're on 60. Never mind. I guess I'm doing it right now.
Yeah.
This is the drinking water.
That's all right.
Okay, so I'm not drinking water to clarify. All right, this is also then, this is to put out bids for Administrator Grimes for the clarifiers and motor replacement project. Mike, do we need this?
Yeah, the motors that are in there now are 45 years old. We hope to get that.
It's an emergency because of the bid process?
We'd like to get that bid process, okay. I guess.
So I move that we'll make a motion that we go ahead and approve this in the first reading.
Second.
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Mary? And Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Six yes to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 60-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 60-16?
So moved.
Second.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Mary?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
And Folks?
Yes.
Six shots to suspend the rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 60-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to adopt under suspension of the rules for ordinance number 60-16.
Second.
Keeson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Six shots to adopt under suspension of the rules for ordinance number 60-2016.
I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 61-16.
So moved.
Second.
Peters?
Yes.
Merrick?
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
And Jason?
Yes.
Six yes to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 61-2016. And ordinance authorizing director of administration of the city of North Canton to advertise and receive bids for the city of North Canton EMS building addition project and authorizing the mayor on board of control approval to enter into a contract for the EMS building addition project and declaring the same to be emergency.
And you're saying?
I was saying right now that this is for the EMS building over there on 7th Street. They're in need of some really living space now. They're sharing female and male, sharing spaces over there, sleeping quarters. So I've been over there and I've seen it, and Dutch has taken me through it, and I really do feel that there is a need. If any of you wish to go over there and make an appointment with Dutch, he'll bring you in. But I think this is important for our people that are over there and they're spending a lot of time over there and, you know, on call at all times, so we give them at least some kind of living quarters where someone comfortable. I invite anybody who goes to go look at that based on what I saw here. It really needs some improvement to it. So I move that we go ahead and approve this at least in the first reading.
Second.
Any discussion?
Okay,
so I can long over.
Yeah.
Long over. Yeah. Thanks, Gus.
What was the amount for example?
$190,000.
Sorry, we have a motion and a second.
Yes.
Sir Reddick?
Yes.
Folds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Keeson?
Yes.
And Peters?
Yes.
Six yes to adopt the first reading of ordinance number
three readings for ordinance number 61-.
So moved.
Second.
Sir Reddick.
Yes.
Folds.
Yes.
Fontaine.
Yes.
Keeson.
Yes.
Peters.
Yes.
And Waring.
Yes.
Six chefs to the federal rules of council for three readings for ordinance number 61-2016.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to adopt under suspension of rules ordinance number 61-16.
So moved. Second.
Folds.
Yes.
Fontaine.
Yes.
Keeson.
Yes.
Peters.
Yes.
Waring.
Yes.
And Sir Reddick.
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt under suspension of rules for ordinance number 61-2016.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 62-16.
So moved.
Second.
Fontaine.
Yes.
Keeson.
Yes.
Peters.
Yes.
Waring.
Yes.
Sir Reddick.
Yes.
And Folds.
Yes.
Six chefs to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 62-2016. An ordinance authorizing the mayor of the city of North Canton pursuant to the Ohio Revised Code 9.48 to participate in joint purchasing programs with other political subdivisions for the purchase of machinery, materials, and supplies used by various city departments, and specifically to join the National Joint Purchasers Alliance for said purchase.
Since Dan isn't here, would you turn this over to Mike and have a little more information on it?
Yeah, it's just we're asking to be able to bid these things out through a national purchasing collaboration, and we already have Ohio, but we also like to do the national one. We've looked at that, and a couple of things we've seen right away is when we resurface the tennis courts and that type of thing, we think we can get cheaper prices that way. So Mr. Davis asked if we had added one more option when we're bidding out our project.
Is that, would that be the first thing you look at?
We'll look at Ohio and then we'll look at national, that'll be the first thing.
Oh, this, okay, I got you. Yeah, this is separate from?
Separate from the Ohio, yes. Yes. Oh. We have actually been looking at, so.
So someone from out of state would come over and do the job?
No, your local vendors also bid on the national contracts too, so.
Okay. All right, very good. Any other questions? Grab that. We're going to have three readings on this, so. I'll entertain a motion in a second to adopt the first reading.
So moved.
Yes.
Peters.
Yes. Waring.
Yes.
Sir Reddick.
Yes.
Folds.
Yes.
Fontaine.
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt the first reading of ordinance number 62-2016.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of resolution number 4-16.
So moved.
Second.
Peters.
Yes.
Waring.
Yes.
Sir Reddick.
Yes.
Folds.
Yes.
Fontaine.
Yes.
Keeson.
Yes.
Six chefs to read by title only the first reading of resolution for 2016, a resolution to impose a moratorium on granting building permits and certificates of occupancy from the building structure use or change of use, which would authorize the cultivation of something from retail sale of medical marijuana for an initial period not to exceed 6 months from the effective date of this resolution, thereby permitting city council and planning commission to more fully analyze applicable federal law, Ohio statutes, and North Canton ordinances relative to such use, and is witnessing to be negligent.
Thank you. Chairwoman Mayor.
Last time, Tim did a really good job explaining kind of where we are with this, and it really just gives us some extra time to understand what the law regarding marijuana does. So let's all the statutes and get this. Right now, but I think we want to do another emergency so that if anybody does either have any permits or leasing space, we're going to
Could we just like make this go on to infinity if we want?
Well, when the 6 month moratorium is up, we wish to extend it if it appears that there isn't sufficient information at that time. Certainly, you may extend it. Right now, I see every day municipalities throughout the state are either doing a moratorium or they're outright banning. Right. Some are remaining quiet, and those may be that their plan is to not do any additional type of local ordinances. But nevertheless, nearly every day newspapers are reporting how municipalities are acting. I think the vast vast majority are going the route of the moratorium unless they have already decided that they intend to ban it.
So right now, with what we know, I go to not.
Second.
Waring?
Yes.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Wilkinson?
Yes.
And Peters?
Yes.
Six yes to adopt the first reading of Resolution 4-2016.
We have a motion and a second to suspend the rules of council for three readings for Resolution Number 4-16. So moved. Second.
Surratt?
Yes.
Golds?
Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Wilkinson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Yes.
Six chefs to suspend the rules of council for three readings for Resolution 4-2016.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to adopt under suspension of the rules of Resolution Number 4-16. So moved. Second. Yes.
Fontaine?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
And Surratt?
Yes.
Six chefs to adopt under suspension of the rules for Resolution 4-2016.
Thank you. Reports, Fontaine.
Okay, so we just passed the Whitward Orchard Street for Hoover and the church, Manny Hoover, for the apartments. And I just got to say, I'm beating this to death. I just want to go on record one more time. Stu Lickner is an awesome guy. He do a lot of good things and gets things done like this. I'd like to see before winter, why can't we get the Hoover project done on the outside? I mean, September is a perfect time to grade it, put a base layer, black top down. Take that ugly fence down, just so we clean it up and make it look so much nicer while we're working on getting funding or whatever it is they're trying to do to get inside. So I think it would be good to ask them to give us a report and see if they would at least do that before winter, and it would clean up the outside and then give us an update on the progress. And is there anything we can do as a council to help speed this process along? Because I know we're a couple years overdue. That's just my opinion.
I did make contact with her through texting, and she said either the 19th or the 26th. I asked her if she could be here tonight, she never responded, but she never responded. I told her the 19th would be better, but I've never heard a response back.
Could you get Stu to come in, or somebody?
Dave has a report.
Good. We'll wait till
I just want to see if you get handled soon, or what can we do, and what's happening.
Yeah, I actually called them after I spoke with them, and got hold of this American. So, Councilman Sorrento is working with Carol Smith to set up a meeting, because Carol is usually the person that manages the projects and handles all the paperwork. And then we have the two partners, Stu Lichter and also Chris Merigin. Chris Merigin, he lives here in Ohio, whereas Stu Lichter lives in California. So call both of them, and Stu Lichter said that he was going to look into it. And then talk to Chris Merigin. Right after I spoke to you, which was between what, 6 and 6:30, and Chris said that they're working on getting the financing complete for the IRG project. I said, well, the front's looking pretty messy, or maybe we should pave it or put grass in it to straighten it out until this financing gets complete. And they said that they plan on having apartments available in the spring. And I said, well, again, we've heard that before. And he said, you know, these development deals, they just take time. And
I'm looking at his Hall of Fame, and I drove by there last week and this week, and everything's demo. Like that, boom, right. Just like that. Right. So if I'm thinking this would be like a one-day project for him to do the outside.
That's how fast that's going.
Yeah, I mean, I drive by there all the time, and I'm amazed at what can happen when you put your mind to it.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, you know, I know that there's finances and all that, but can we just do the landscaping and just get the outside cleaned up?
I made it real clear. So I said, because really what's going to happen is not going to work so good. You know, you've done a very good job as far as, you know, redeveloping that property. But when you look at the outside portion, Ryan Warner's still looking. I mean, it's just not something that wants to.
I'm telling you, a guy at that power level could knock us out on Saturday to Sunday.
Right. So we're going to meet with them.
We work on Saturdays and Sundays.
Mark's got a meeting set up, so we can have that.
Yeah, whatever we can help.
I think it's clear we're all very frustrated and not done. I don't think there's anybody that questions that at all. So we just need to keep pushing. Just every avenue we have.
Also, so on. nothing's communicated. That's what bothers me.
Yeah.
So I'll try to confirm with her, and then see what we're doing. In very polite way, of course.
Of course.
Yes.
Number where?
No report.
Caitlin?
No report.
Mr. Sorrell? Well, first of all, I think we should wish. Last 2 weekends ago, I believe, Jessica got married. So, Jess, are you still married, Jess? And that went well, I take it. It was a destination wedding. I wasn't invited, but
I wasn't either.
We had a great time, Mark. No, just to
congrats, Jess. It might change your schedule a little bit.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Go home early for a change.
Some of you may have saw that there's people working on the guard shack out there.
Nice.
I talked to Steve Kuhn over the last couple weeks, and he told his guys he wanted it done by Friday, this Friday. And usually when he tells them that, you see there's a local painter out there, a guy volunteered to work with Steve and do that, but they've got some things they've got to do. Dave McDaniels is the president of the Heritage Society. They're basically now taking control of that, and then they're going to put panels in the window before and after of North Canton, show the heritage, and then the Heritage Society will kind of showcase some of the heritage of North Canton with it. So they'll be taking the air conditioner out, so nobody whacks their head on it, and kid, and they'll be, you know, just kind of straightening up some of the stuff that was spent during the move. But for the most part, the inside is going to look just like the Heritage Society does not want to touch the inside. They want people to look in and see 19 whatever, you know. So that'll be going. You'll see that going. As far as the pool is concerned, we've got people, if you've been out there, they're digging away out there. Our guys have jumped right on that after it was closed. We're putting some drains in around the side, some extra concrete. First of all, the drains and everything are minimal cost, but the contractor is paying for the majority of all this. They're going to be reseeding them with a split seeder with some of the top seeds, like sports seed, because some of those areas, we do not want them to sit here and talk about grass in the spring. So they're really on that. And we're putting in some extra concrete for, they weren't taking consideration when people were waiting in line and went back into the grass, and that dripped water and that created a lot of wearing out of the grass. So they're just extending the lines and areas right there. So Jim Davis and his crew is on that, and I was out there today, and they're really going at it, so that's good. And hopefully the contract will be seen in this week. Let's see here. And I think that's all I had for reports.
That's good. Thank you. Number four.
No report.
All right, just a quick note here. I think I left my phone at home, and I asked some of my friends to text me to see how the live streaming was going.
Oh, it's going very well. I thought when I was going to watch it. Yeah, it's up.
All right. The audio was good.
I haven't heard anything. It's about a 15-second delay, but it
depends on the speaker, how loud the speaker is right now. So we're still trying to figure that out. Make sure.
Oh,
what were you saying about how many people?
Hello?
Three, including me.
It shows how many people are on there. Very good. Well, I anticipate more and more.
Okay, do you want to say no?
Yeah, I don't know about
it. If you can put it in the newsletter, streaming, I think that's a great spot to announce it. I mean, just so the people know.
And I think we're,
Jesse.
And the reason I mentioned that, I just wanted to make note because I cringed a couple times today. And I know we've been doing this a lot, you know, we're very careful with our words. We're very measured, I think. You know, sometimes we, you know, as politicians, we talk too much, but there are two references tonight that made me cringe. And I would just ask those two gentlemen, you know who you are, just to choose your words a little more carefully, because there are people that maybe watching that might be a little more sensitive to that than it may be you as well. So,
and I'm sure that some of the schools are going to use it to show their government classes and so on.
Yes. Yes. So,
that's it.
Director Block?
Yes, sir. I just want to be clear, there were some allegations about what some think in judging what they believe may be the law director's opinion on some things. And I don't know if they know exactly what those opinions may be, because I've not given it to them, because indeed they're not public officials. But what I do want to be clear about is that the city is looking quite closely. those very issues and for maybe the past 3 months, it feels as though I've worked on little else but that. But at this very moment, it doesn't appear appropriate to give full disclosure of everything that I've evaluated and what I'm looking at now. I can only assure you that the legislation that they're trying to put forward is, as I said, simply to make it transparent the areas that we have state certification to offer the tax abatements. We have looked at the application, absolutely. And your Matlock search there disclosed the same thing that disclosed to us. There are issues with that application, and we're looking at those quite closely. I think where perhaps someone may have misled you a little bit is that we don't have, as a municipal body, the authority to take away a tax abatement, something like that. There's a process, and we'll be obligated to follow that process. We're looking at it quite closely because, indeed, so much is at stake. So we wish to do it correctly. And that dovetails into one other issue in that we have been waiting for an opinion from Judge Haas regarding the parking lot expansion at the Hoover South lot. And we've been actually waiting for a bit of time on that, but the time was, I guess, well spent. We were simply trying to show that we believe our planning commission followed the rules correctly and that council's determination in affirming the planning commission's decision to award the conditional use permit to expand the parking lot was correct. And indeed, the Common Pleas Court agreed with council and affirmed its decision. So we're happy about that. It appears that the parking lot expansion will remain because the process was followed and we had the affirmation from an independent third party. So that's good on our planning commission. It's good on council. It shows we followed the rules and implemented those correctly.
Thank you, sir. Director of Administration.
First off, the engineer, just for the record, he's off tonight because I sent him home. He's quite ill, even though he was here probably until about 6 o'clock tonight, making sure his grant was ready to go in case he doesn't make it in. But we didn't want him around because he'll affect the rest of us, so that's why he's not here tonight. And the chief is out here, and instead of setting up a particular time, the chief said that, you know, anytime during the day or early evening hours, if you want to visit DMS, just go there. You don't need to call him. He's fine with you just showing up, and, you know, any of the captains can take you through and show you anything that you want to see there. So, you know, pretty much above board on what we need there. So, and I know many of you have been through that anyhow, quite a bit. So. And then the last thing is, I just appreciate you passing what we really need to pass in emergency. I appreciate you doing that, so thank you. Thanks, Mr. Mayor.
Yes, just to comment on the few items. The first one, the CRA, just to give a brief summary on where we're at with the CRA. The CRA, clearly, there's no council member here. There are myself, previous mayors. As I've talked to Daryl, we've both at length over this. We've talked about it. Previous council members about this. The CRA, clearly there was no one that intended for the North Bridge Apartments to have an $860,000 plus abatement for 13 years. And as Mr. Saylor mentioned, it should be 15 years if we were being consistent with the ordinances. We did discover that. Actually, Tim Fox, our law director, discovered that when he was doing his comprehensive review of the CRA, that particular one. And on top of that, just to make sure that we're covering all the bases, we did give Berger and Eckler, which are a very reputable firm, to also do an overall assessment of the work that Tim Fox is doing. So I'm confident that we're going to handle this correctly. But it's similar to, and then as Mr. Peterson mentioned, council does pass the legislation. They pass it and we administer it. When you look at the administration of this, clearly myself and Mike Grimes and the new permit superintendent, there are things that we would not do the next time around. My daughter Audrey, who was in eighth grade, she said, "Dad, I've got a few friends over," and I said, "I think you can." And on the driveway, there was about 35 eighth graders in the cul-de-sac. You know, what's going on? Is there a parade here? Of course, I'm thinking that it could be my child that is the cause of all of this. And I asked my daughter, "What's the problem?" He said, "I got about two friends over." I'm thinking, well, a few, I'm thinking three or four. But, you know, one person texts another before you know it, you've got a whole group of kids there. Well, it's, you know, 9 o'clock at night. It's not like I can send them all home, because many of them were driven in by their parents. So it's a similar thing with this CRA. You know, it's pretty clear that it wasn't intended by this council, or my crimes, or myself, or the law director. And so now as we go through and we try to correct it, we've got to make sure that we're doing it properly. Because you have to keep in mind that you do have the recipient of the CRA. And you know, there are documents that have been signed and approved for the next 13 years. It should have been 15 if we were being consistent with that. And so now we've got to make sure and correct it. But, you know, we could have went through, and I did think about this. Oh, well, the housing council, we'll overturn it. Well, Melanie, I spoke with you about that, Mary. You know, number one, that would be a decision of the housing council. Well, let's say that they did that. It doesn't necessarily mean that it would fall within in court. So we are strategically going about this, following the process, and we're going to make sure that this gets resolved. And the next thing is, when you look at the traffic light, Gary, thank you for bringing that up, because oftentimes there's things that people can drive by, you know, every day. I don't go that route very often, so it's something I wouldn't notice. So I'm glad you can bring that up and make sure we get that correct. The zoning on no parking, Mr. Tripp, you brought that up too. You know, keep in mind that in North Canton, we're one of the few political subdivisions, when you look at townships, municipalities, villages, that has no parking at night. Any night during the week, there's no parking, which is a good thing because it's easier for our police officers to patrol. But at the same time, it puts an extra burden on residents that have to put multiple cars in the driveway. So I appreciate council looking at this. Our intention is not to degrade the city, it's to make it to improve it, being sensitive to all the residents and at the same time enhancing it. And then Gary Fry, he's going to be starting tomorrow. He'll be the superintendent of permits and also the director of development. So he'll be in charge of economic development. He'll be in charge of permits, inspections, nuisances. Very impressive guy. Whenever we hire somebody in the city, we look at their character first, and then secondly, we look at their talent, their ability. And he's got a very strong character, very good reputation. And he's also very talented, too, because he was a community planner for two municipalities in Utah. But he's lived in North Canton now, I believe, over 10 years. And he has five kids. He's a good man, and so looking forward to him starting tomorrow. And then lastly, you know, when with Tim Fox. Tim, myself, I think that he does an excellent job as an attorney for the city. And I think that, you know, Tim's approach is pretty technical. He's a very legalistic attorney in that he doesn't shoot from the hip at all. Anytime that I've asked him for anything, or Mike Grimes has asked him for anything, you know, he does, you know, kill mosquitoes with sledgehammers, I think, sometimes. Because he'll give you every Supreme Court decision that was ever written on a particular subject. And I know you're laughing, you know, because it's true. He does do the over, you know, what I would consider to be the overkill. But when you're covering yourself legally, that's what you need. You know, it is a little bit different administratively, as Mike Grimes says, that sometimes you have to shoot for 80% because you just don't have so many decisions to make. You can't make everything perfect. really does strive to make all of the legal opinions perfect. There's no doubt about that. And as I look at this, when I first started as mayor, I had a rough first 2 years, as most of you know, because I was pretty intense. I think I was insensitive at times, but it wasn't because I was trying to be mean. It's just, I'm trying to prove myself. Some areas I didn't feel as confident as I would have liked. And so you try to overcompensate, at least I did, being a little more intense. And I think with Tim, he was, when he got started here, he was, intense. I mean, he was an intense guy. I was like, wow, that was rough. And I think maybe he was, insensitive to people in our audience. And I've talked to him about that. But I think he's made a change. And so what I'd ask Larry and Glenn and Melanie and Chuck, Chuck and I, we've had the opportunity to grow our relationship over 15 years. And it has been not an easy thing, but we are very civil with each other. Oftentimes we don't always agree, but we're kind of, Northridge, we definitely agree on that. So the thing is, this is just my own observation, my own opinion. I think that Tim Fox does an excellent job as an attorney, and I think that he's very, very intense, and I think that his approach in the council chambers when he first got started, just like when I first got started, was very, very intense, and sometimes maybe insensitive to people in the audience. But I think he made a big change, and he's working on it. And just as I'm working on it, and everybody else here is working on it. So what I would ask is, I think Melanie, it's like, give everybody a chance. And I think that Tim's been improving. And I think also, it's up to you. You can all take whatever approach you want. You can laugh about it. I don't think it's funny, though. I mean, I think it's really about, having my respect for people. And some of the comments that were made tonight were really, really upsetting to me. And I found personally offensive, Chuck, the comments you made. I found them really personally offensive. Now see, my intense side is coming out right now because when I get personally offended, it starts to come out, which is probably not a good thing. So I'm gonna back off because I've got more experience since I've been here now a few years. Just like Tim is starting to back off, but I think the same thing should be extended to the people here. And so now that I'm gonna leave my intense side back, Chief, if you don't mind coming up here and giving us a quick update on the on a positive thing.
Can I just say one more thing?
Yeah.
Like this from a little bit I've been with everybody here. I know we get paid a bit for not being, diversified enough, but I can say right now, I know the heart of the guys I work with up here, including Attorney Fox. And even though the perception sometimes is not right, the heart is always the right spot.
Yes.
And I know that everybody here wants to do it right. So if we make a mistake, it's brought to our attention. We don't want it to be wrong. We want it to be right. And we're not all experts in all fields. We're laymen. We have jobs, families. So we want to become good at what we do. So that's why we go to the law director. We go to someone with more experience. And like I said, even Chuck, he's very knowledgeable about things. And Chuck brings something to me that, hey, you need to do this. But I'll look at it, And if it's something that's correct, then let's do it. We don't want to do things wrong. We want to do it right. We're here for the people. We're not here for ourselves. It doesn't pay near enough for the headaches sometimes we go through. That's just my two cents on the China. Okay, sorry.
No, I agree. It's always, we always like to judge everybody by their actions, but then we want people to judge us by our intentions. It's like, my intentions were good. So it's like sometimes you got to step back and look at that. That's just my other opinion. And Chief, if you don't mind just sharing, we've got an open house. Two of them coming up, right?
Yeah.
What's that?
Yes,
I'm looking
at that. That's the
players. Monday, October 10th, right? 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. and October 12th on Wednesday, 6 to 8 p.m.
That's correct. Required to mention them.
And also a reminder, replace smoke alarms every 10 years.
Okay.
And we'll have refreshments there too, right?
Yeah, except for Mr. Grimes, I'm not allowed to drink popcorn.
Yeah.
I know Halloween's coming up, but we get some oil on the squeaky doors.
Yes.
Yeah. And you probably should discuss when Halloween's going to be again.
it's too far away from us. You know, it's,
we've received calls for it.
31st.